Got a book of early stories waiting on the shelf, and you finished one this morning about old proper English. Well, maybe next you'll pick a caper or some scheming satire. A point of view and context prove our consequences dire. Catch up with the living, might you dabble in the dead and revisit some grand verse from the romantic period. Perhaps some telling passage universally germane, bespeckled with old pin marks from your school anthology. Make the time turn those pages over and over. Well, some say words are good for nothing and poetry's a hoax, so pull your eggs out of that basket before you end up going broke. 'Cause there's a rhyme around each corner out there begging for a dime. So if you're smart, you'll close that cover and forget your silly lines. 'Cause there's no time to turn those pages over and over. There's no time to turn those pages over and over again. And over again. Well, all the world's on television, but the stories are a bore. There's no foreshadowed complications or resounding metaphors. We seek our satisfaction in each channel that we change. Absent of true meaning, we go blind along the way. So you extend your admiration for the critically acclaimed, spend hours searching bookshelves for your literary face. Like Bob and Roth and Cather Updike, McGraw and Richard Ford, McCarthy, Carver, Cheever, Brule, and Hemingway, of course. Make the time turn those pages over and over. Make the time turn those pages over and over. Time turn those pages over and over again. And over again.